Okay. So Leah, we know there are different phases. We might not know much about what these different phases are in the approval process for a clinical trial to go from research to hitting the market. What is this process?
Sure. So it's a rigorous process, Stephanie. And you know, what's important to understand is that any therapy that's approved today, whether it's a chemotherapy or a different cancer therapy, or even something over the counter that you can go pick up at CVS or Walgreens, at one point was in a clinical trial. And so before a clinical trial even starts, the research begins in the lab setting. And so researchers take either a new treatment, or maybe it's a combination of drugs that have never been put together before, and they test it in either petri dishes or animals to really see if that is safe and promising in that setting. And if it is, it can go through the very arduous process of becoming a formal clinical trial. And so the first phase of clinical trial, a phase one, is considered first in human. It's a very small number of patients, usually around 30. And the goal of a phase one clinical trial is to determine what is the optimal dose. So the highest dose with the least amount of side effects. And so within that small group of patients, researchers give a group of patients a certain dose. And then if that is well tolerated, give a different group of patients a higher dose and keep doing that until they determine what that optimal dose is. After they've determined that, it can move into a phase two clinical trial. And this phase has slightly more patients, somewhere around 100 or so. And at this point, researchers say, okay, we have this new treatment that is safe, but does it actually work the way we had hoped? And so every clinical trial is set up differently in terms of what outcome measures it's striving to meet. The focus of that phase two trial is to see if they can achieve those outcomes. And so again, this phase can take another year or two as well. Now, there are many more phase one and phase two trials than there are phase three, which I'll talk about. And the reasons for that are A, they never have enough patients accrue, as I mentioned before, and they have to close, or they may never meet those measurements or those goals at each phase. But at the end of a phase two, if the research team has a treatment that is safe and effective, it can move into a phase three. And this is where there are two groups of patients. One group gets whatever is being studied, this new treatment, and the other group of patients is getting whatever is considered the gold standard or approved therapy. And what researchers want to know is our new treatment as good, if not better, than what is considered the gold standard? And at that point, that's when a new treatment can go forward with FDA approval and be accessible to the rest of the public. Phase four trials are when something has gone through the prior steps and become FDA approved, there can be a more long-term analysis of side effects and effectiveness, and that would be considered a phase four trial.
So thank you, Leah.